Hey, this is Mike Zwick from If Not For God podcast. Our show, Stories of Hopelessness Turned Into Hope. Your chosen Truth Network podcast is starting in just seconds. Enjoy it. Share it. But most of all, thank you for listening and for choosing the Truth Podcast Network.
This is the Truth Network.
Alice, at last.
This case is real. So are you, and so is the Hatter.
And the Jabberwocky. Remember, the Vorpal Sword knows what it wants. All you have to do is hold on to it.
The sun'll come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may.
Welcome to the Christian Car Guy Radio Show.
I say this calls for action, and now.
Day by day, day by day, oh dear Lord, three things I pray, to see thee more clearly, love thee more dearly, follow thee.
Take hold of your VARPLE sword. It knows what it wants.
Yeah, Robbie, this is it. Yeah,
this is the name of today's show. Take hold of your VARPLE sword because it knows what it wants. And I'm so blessed to be here with my good friend Jerry from Race Body Shop and Record Service. And if you listened carefully to the beginning, you heard a caterpillar. If you're familiar with Alice in Wonderland, Lewis Carroll's unbelievable classic, there was a caterpillar named Absalom, and he says something very, very important. Alice at last. In other words, Alice has been trying to figure out who Alice is all the way through the book slash movie, whatever you're trying to do. But the thing of it is, she is going to have to take on the Jabberwocky. And I don't know if you're like me, I've taken him on three or four times this week. And so she's going to have to take on the Jabberwocky, and it's going to require the VARPLE sword. And Absalom gives her an unbelievable clue to life. The more I've thought about this over the years, the more I see how wonderful it is. The VARPLE sword knows what it wants. All you have to do is hold on to it. Now, you may not even know that you have a VARPLE sword, but that's where we're going today. And in order to know what to do with your VARPLE sword, you have to remember the sun will come out tomorrow, right? Annie knew it, and so did the people who did Godspell, or I think that was the name of the musical, the day-by-day thing. And the person that really knew this, perhaps better than anybody I know scripturally other than Jesus himself or God, would be King David. Because King David, clearly, right, he took on the Jabberwocky in the form of Goliath, and he had a hold of the VARPLE sling. And away you go. So Monday morning, I can just walk you through how I got here and where I'm going, and so just be patient with me. And yes, we have some really cool stuff. The Jesus, Labor, Love is undoubtedly one of God's VARPLE swords, and this week we were able, with the phenomenally generous gift of several donors, and was just a beautiful Acura car that we gave to a single mom that is a reliable car. If you could have been there, it's so awesome. We have pictures of it at christiancarguy.com and the whole VARPLE sword page. So, and we're going to get a call from Scott Barton, our Jesus Labor Love volunteer, who walked us through all that. So we're going to talk about that today too. So Monday, I'm praying day by day, and I hope you are too. And so I'm looking for the sun to come up, because every day is just an opportunity for God to shine down. And as I'm praying, all of a sudden, I get a vision, I guess that's the best way to put it, of two Hebrew letters. And these Hebrew letters are an I and a Zion, but let me be more specific on what I'm seeing. What I'm seeing is something that looks like a yoke, okay, like a yoke you would put on oxen, like you're fixing to go plow. And I'm seeing a plow. Okay, well, those two pictures are an Ion and a Zion. And I'm like, so are you showing me this, God? He goes, yeah. Well, I don't know what that word is, but I'm just saying, well, here's two Hebrew letters. I'll bet that's a word that God wants me to dig into, right? And so you think about being yoked up to a plow. I mean, it seemed like a pretty cool thing. And so as I just put that in the way I find stuff like that, all of a sudden the word is strength. An Ion or a yoke and a plow means strength, which took me immediately, when you look at that word and you want to do a study on it, go to the 68th Psalm, and we're going to spend some time here. And what an opportunity to pray, because if you think about being yoked to the plow, it's prayer. I mean, take on my yoke, right? Jesus tells us, and, you know, here's what's kind of going. Well, the more I've thought about this word all week long, the more I've seen of more of what God was showing me in this, that every single person you ever met is a reflection of God. They bear God's image in some very unique ways, and they've been all given gifts, especially if they're in Christ, they're given very specific gifts in order to plow very specifically in the way that God gave them very unique ways to plow. But of course, you got to be yoked to Christ in order to plow the plow that you're supposed to plow. Well, the Zion is not only a plow, but if you look at it in the more current Hebrew scripture, it is also a sword. Okay? And when you think about what you could have a sword all you want, but if you don't know where to use it, you're kind of out of luck, right? Or you could have a plow all the way, you know, but if you don't have a field to go plow in, you're kind of out of luck. And so as I went to study this Psalm, I saw something really, really amazing at the very beginning. King David, as he is writing it, says, the very first words are, let God arise. And as I started to think about that word arise, which has a letter in it that actually looks like the sun coming up, okay? And I started thinking about this, wow, when the sun comes up, we see it from our perspective that the sun is coming up above the horizon, and it's going to go up all the way and then come down, right? But what's actually happening is sun rays are now able, through, you know, the way the earth is rotated, to now the sun rays can actually come down, right? And so as those sun rays come down, if you're like me and you get a chance to go out early in the morning hunting sometime, especially this time of year, you will note that it won't be long after those sun rays come down, all the animals come out to enjoy, right? The sun comes out, and here come the animals, and the squirrels are usually first, or there'll be a bird or two. Next thing you know, the birds are chirping. They're in the sun, and they'll find a place in an open field where they can just soak up the rays, because the blood, you know, in a cold-blooded animal is trying to heat up. And next thing, here come the deer, right? That's why deer hunters hunt them. And they'll be walking out there, and you'll see all the different animals that will come to enjoy the sun every morning. Now, guess what? God comes out every morning. The real sun, the Son of God. Okay? It just does. And that same letter, Ion, can also be translated as your eyes. Okay? It's a yoke, but it also can be eyes. And so with your eyes, you take in light. Well, with your heart's eyes, right? And think about that song that we just heard from, you know, Godspell, which was to see thee more clearly, right? Well, how are you going to know where to yield your VARPLE sword if you can't see? You got to have light. And Jesus is the light of the world. And so if you can get in his word in the morning, and begin to see what he has for you this day, you can take up your VARPLE sword. Now, the question I have for all of us, and I'm hoping you'll call in today and share, is where have you seen very uniquely either your VARPLE sword or somebody else's VARPLE sword, and you've seen how they used it? Now, I would never have known about my one very unique VARPLE sword had I not done this show. But almost anybody I meet, when they talk about, oh, I've heard you on the radio, I love your laugh. Okay. Well, the joy of the Lord is my strength. I mean, it just is. I mean, I don't know how it happened, but I never would have guessed in a million years that one of my VARPLE swords just happens to be my laugh. And so how cool is it is I get a better look at Christ every morning. Guess what I do? I laugh. But note, curiously, the VARPLE sword knows what it wants. That's what Absalom told Alice. Well, a lot of times I laugh at really strange times. I
just really?
Anybody who's been around me knows that you never know when Robbie's VARPLE sword's going to come out. And you know, there you go. So the question is that I want you to call in and share is, where have you seen that? Maybe in your husband, or maybe you've seen it in your pastor. Where did you see their VARPLE sword? And just kind of show us their glory. How has God reflected in that? And how is that used to plow, to build the kingdom? You know, what does that look like? 866-348-7884. So much more coming up.
You're listening to the Truth Network and TruthNetwork.com.
Remember, the VARPLE sword knows what it wants. All you have to do is hold on to it.
The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may.
Day by day, day by day.
Take hold of your VARPLE sword. It knows what it wants today on the Christian Car Guy Show. That thought that we talked about in the first segment is, where do you see God's glory in someone else? Or maybe you see it in yourself. And you go, how is God using that? And when they take hold of it, you can see the smile on their face. You can see they absolutely love what they're doing. Some people sing. Some people you know, I have a granddaughter who loves to act. When you see her in a play or something, you can just see the joy in her heart that's going up. Ann Alt, you know, you've seen her take hold of her VARPLE sword, whatever that. If you listen to Christian Car Guy Theater, you clearly could see or you know, those different players. But, you know, it's really neat. My wife loves to hold babies. I mean, it's just like, and it knows what it wants when she does that. So what does that look like in somebody that you love or in somebody that you're familiar with? I would love to hear your story. 866-348-7884 is the number to call in and share. And again, that's what makes this show to me, is I love to hear these stories. I just do. And Jerry, what does that bring up in your mind?
Well, you know, as you're even talking about that, one of the things I'm just sitting here thinking, because you just mentioned it sort of in passing, is the fact of what other people, just like with your laugh, you wouldn't think that would be your gift, and you wouldn't think that would bring joy to people and reflect Christ. I think sometimes, and I know for myself, and probably I'm sure I'm not the only person, I almost need other people to tell me what it is. And I think if you really are struggling with, you know, what is God's purpose for me? What gift has God given me? Probably ask a few of your closest friends, and you're going to probably be amazed how many of them are going to tell you the same thing. And you're going, no, that's not me, or I never would have thought that, because a lot of times people see things in us that we're too busy searching, we overlook it.
Yeah, overthink it.
Yeah.
Yeah, which, you know, when you think about Alice in that movie, I really recommend it, that you'll see she's searching, she's thinking too hard because it's right there in front of her, and it's absolutely beautiful when you see somebody come into their identity of, yeah, and you can just see the joy, and you can see the effectiveness of what God's doing in that.
And sometimes we will gravitate to what we see other people bringing joy to other people in. So we think, you know what, that's who I want to be, or that's how I want God to be able to use me, and we can miss the blessing just because we're just, like you said, overthinking it, trying to, yeah. I mean, I know I'm one for that. I mean, sometimes I'll feel like I'm pushing the square peg in the round hole, but most often just step back and just take a moment and see where God is leading you. It's amazing what the path He'll lead and walk with you on.
Yeah, and so, 8 months ago, 10 months ago, we were praying. A lot of us were praying on the Christian Car Guy Show. We needed help with the Jesus Labor Love. We need somebody with those gifts, the gift of prayer, the gift of compassion to help single moms, widows. And clearly, when we look at the 68th Psalm here in a little bit, you'll see all the compassion that God has for that. But Scott Barton is, he showed up, and he had such a heart. And
does he know how much prayer brought him here?
Yeah, I don't know if he does. But he's here with us, and I got him on the line. And Scott, we had a big week in the Jesus Labor of Love, didn't we? God really showed up, and that VARPLE sword started cutting out some joy for some people, didn't it? You with me, Scott?
I sure am. Good morning.
Good morning.
Wow, what a great week. Yeah, I've just been sitting here listening, and Jerry has a good point. A lot of times we don't know what our own blessing is, and we see things and reflect on others. But I think it's up to us just to try to be ourselves and let God bring out our own qualities. I know with myself, I love to listen. I'm very curious, so I ask a lot of questions. So if I have a sword, I guess that would be it. I don't know. But what a blessing it is, the Jesus Labor of Love. It has been such a blessing, and we did have a good week. And I just want to really lift up the donors and the people that are involved. We were fortunate enough to donate a used vehicle to a person this week, and they've been overjoyed. And I just want to thank the whole community and everybody that's involved with the Jesus Labor of Love. It's been a blessing for me to be used as a vessel in this endeavor.
Yeah, and this one went, and believe it or not, I've been through this process a few times of giving away a car, and if you think it's easy, it isn't easy. Because you've got to find the right person. They've got to be in a position to really get the insurance, get the car, be able to properly maintain all those things, or you're not necessarily helping anybody. And this one just went like, couldn't you tell, Scott, God was behind this?
Absolutely, Robbie. And we've been praying since, I guess, around Thanksgiving. And I've been speaking to, I will say her first name, Brittany, since we wanted it to happen the week of Christmas, but it wasn't in God's time. And I told her just be patient, and she was, and she was obedient and did everything and did all the steps. And she was just so overjoyed. So we were able to deliver the car this week, and she's now the owner of a Honda Acura.
Yeah, it's a really nice car.
God is great.
And the donor donated a bunch of stuff to make sure the car was totally up to snuff. It was just absolutely gracious. And Jerry is curious, is that the applicant that had the Ford that was involved in an accident?
No, not. It was not.
Okay, another one. But you were able to help several single moms this week, right?
It was a great week. I think there was four that had their car fixed, and one of them is actually in the shop today as we speak.
Yeah, that's so wonderful, Scott. Thank you for calling in. I just wanted to share how God used the VARPLE sword of the Jesus Labor Love this week. We got Nancy is in Chapel Hill. She's holding on to share her VARPLE sword story, but we would love to hear yours. 866-348-7884. So much more coming up.
You're listening to the Truth Network and truthnetwork.com.
Remember, the VARPLE sword knows what it wants. All you have to do is hold on to it.
The sun'll come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may,
day by day by day. Oh dear Lord, three things I pray to see thee more clearly.
So take hold of your VARPLE sword today on the Christian Car Guy Show. It knows what it wants. And I'm just anxious to hear your stories because they're lining up now on the phone. So first off, we have Nancy, who's in Chapel Hill. She's been hanging on for a whole segment. So Nancy, good morning. Welcome to Christian Car Guy Show.
Good morning, Robbie. You know I love to call in. I love to hear you, too.
Well, thank you.
The VARPLE sword, you were talking about when you see it in someone. There was someone who made such an impact that was part of our church family. She had recently passed away. Her name was Barbara, and she had severe Alzheimer's, dementia. She wouldn't even remember the question that you had just, or the answer you had just given her from the question before. But I loved having her as my prayer partner when we would break up into smaller groups during our prayer meetings, because I'll tell you, she was always spot on with what we were talking about or what I needed to hear. You know, she would frequently say, hey, you need to be bolder. Lord, help us be bolder with spreading your word. But there were many other times, and I just saw Christ come through with her. And she was never afraid to put input into the group. And that was her sword, I'll tell you. It was just wonderful to be with her. And one thing I see with you, not only your laugh, but when you start to explain the different words or letters during your sermons and talks, your eyes just light up, and I learned so much from that, too. And that is so unique to you, Robbie. So it's not just your laugh. It's that bit where you can take it and see things in it and explain it more. It's wonderful.
Well, thank you, Nancy.
As far as myself, I really think I have to ask other people. But one thing that does come through a lot is my patients always say about how I can see the good in them and understand the position they're in, kind of like an empathy or compassion. So maybe that's mine.
Well, it's really beautiful, Nancy. I have to jump in and say a couple things. That number one, I know Barbara. But I never got a chance to pray with her before she passed away. But you spotted something there, right?
Definitely.
And she had a sword. She was plowing up ground because the church that Nancy goes to is Peace Church in Durham, I'll just tell you. And that is the church of James Banks, who does encouraging prayer here on the Truth Network, who wrote the book, The Prayers for Prodigals. Okay, so to get the whole picture, this is a church that plows some serious ground when it comes to prayer. I'm just telling you, they do. And isn't it amazing? Don't you think it's amazing, Nancy, that God put so many gifted? I mean, because I know a lot of your members, as I get an opportunity to speak there quite often, is how God assembled such a prayer team there at Peace because of, clearly, Pastor James's VARPLE sword, right?
Yes, definitely.
So that's just that's just beautiful. Thank you, Nancy. I can tell you, the ability to spot God's glory in other people is a huge gift. And if I were to say, just when you see that in your patients, when you see that in your friends, you know, you're actually seeing God. You're getting that light, you know, that we get day by day. When we get to see God in other people is a phenomenal gift. So God bless you. Thank you so much for sharing today.
Oh, and thank you for sharing that, too. It brought to mind the fact that my daughter said, Mom, I don't know how you do it, but you always see good in everybody. You know?
Awesome.
So Yeah, maybe that is. Thank you, Robbie.
Sure,
and,
God bless. Thank
God
you.
God bless.
You too. Bye-bye. So next up, we have Ann Alt herself, right? Speaking of the VARPLE actor. And you're on the Christian Cargo Show.
You guys are so funny. It's so much fun listening. It's so funny. I was not going to call in today. I stayed up till 4 o'clock this morning and all that jazz. But I'm so glad I did, because I was just going to tell you about my verbal sword. But first of all, yes, I love your laugh. I love it when you and I laugh together, because, man, you have to laugh in these crazy times.
Yes, you
and
do.
And for you and Jerry and the way you share and then the way you have these glorious verbal puzzles, it's wonderful. It's like to follow the yellow brick road. I mean, you know, just following all of this marvelous stuff, it really woke me up. Let's just put it that way. But anyway, I'll be very quick because I know you have others. But, I just love you guys so much and being a part of Christian Car Guy Theater and everything. You're right. It lights up it just lights me up, you know. But my verbal sword, I just love all of this. But, you know, I'm always singing at my part-time job at this lovely church near me. And it's a miracle job and great exercise and nice people there when they are there. They're not much there these days. But I was cleaning and I go into the empty sanctuary and I sing to the Lord and I just pray. So it's been an amazing job. But this past week, the sound guy, Brad, my buddy, he's at the church, and I was talking with him and I just started singing, "Here Comes the Sun, do 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 do." Remember that song?
Oh yeah,
that
of course.
Singing
it fit
that.
Perfect for today. Yeah.
It was perfect. And you know what? He turned on the music. It's an old Beatles song. And he got it up on his computer, just the two of us in the church, and we're saying, "Here comes the sun," doo-doo-doo-doo. And the words, you know those words, "Little darling, it's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, it seems like years since you've been gone. Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo, here comes the sun." I just couldn't believe it when you had all of this, and I thought, praise God.
Yes. Yes, because that sun does come up every morning. And
yes, it does.
And I know you, I know Jerry, you know, those of us who can absolutely delight in that morning time with God. We since Beth Ann's come back, our producer, she reinstituted real devotions at Truth Broadcasting again. And so it's kind of fun for me because I have my devotions and we come in and do it as a group here at 9 o'clock since Beth Ann. You've been back and it brings the sun every morning, doesn't it? Just a Truth Broadcast.
It really does, actually. Yes. And, you know, and that's when, Robbie, you know, your VARPLE sword really shows itself. And it's true. We always learn because you add about, that reminds me of the Hebrew letter I was just studying this morning. And God came. So, I mean, and we're all just, you know, captivated by the word. Yeah. By the word of God. Yeah.
It's beautiful. Amen. Yeah. So thank you, Beth. But then, wow, and Ann. So it's an ending.
Yeah.
Oh, bless
you. Couldn't
you guys
get any better, I tell you.
Yes, yes, it can.
Amen, brother.
That's so true. That's so true. So you see it, Jerry, clearly, you know, and that's the beauty of the Christian Car Guy Show, right? You get to see this every day because you have so many godly customers that come in, right?
Yeah, and I think so many times we can, sort of what we talked about is how God places us in places where we can serve him. And it may be at a body shop in a record service. It could be at the Providence Lane at a radio station, the dealership, food line at K&W. It doesn't matter. Wherever God put us, he calls us to be that to be our mission field. And when we take that to heart, and then all of a sudden, when you reflect that, it's amazing how people see that in you, and they're more open up. They'll open up and you know, some days I can spend a day and some of the people walk through the door and just some of the conversations, I think, you know, man, what a day. I mean, I've sat there and had people, cried with people with things going on in their life and rejoiced with them also. And that's one of the cool things about my job. It's not just, I don't just have customers. After a while, we build relationships. And you've been in the car business. That's just so important. And when you do that and let Christ be the center of that and be the what binds us together, man, he can use it in a powerful way.
He does. He does, because, you know, he's there amongst us. And he sees that, and other people see it, and hunger for that kind of community. So we got so much more VARPLE sorting to do, and we can't do it without you. So you got to call us. 866-348-7884.
You're listening to the Truth Network and TruthNetwork.com.
Remember, the VARPLE sword knows what it wants. All you have to do is hold on to it.
The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may.
Day by day, day by day. Oh, dear Lord, three things I pray. To see thee more clearly, love thee more dearly.
Take hold of your VARPLE sword. It knows what it wants. Today on the Christian Car Guys show, we're having so much fun. Of course, it'd be having more fun if you called in. And I, you know, I guess since I've done this a while, a long time,
a day or two.
I had a listener yesterday tell me, said, Robbie, I've been listening to you all my life. He was a young man, but I was like, whoa, all your life you've been listening to me. That was really a compliment. It was just amazing. But one of the listeners that you'll often hear calling, his name is Keith, has a beautiful voice, and so he called me this week because he had been sensing God's presence, and he said, you know, Robbie, Jesus doesn't wear a mask. And he wasn't being sacrilegious at all. What he was saying is when you're really intimate with somebody, you want to see their face, you want to see their mouth, you want to see their eyes, you want to see, you know, you want that closeness. And I think we're all feeling a certain bit of deprivation from that. So we need a little more sun. We need a little more S-U-N, right, to make up for all the sun we're not getting through people's facial expressions and those kind of things. And so that's what's going on. And some of the sun that you might get a chance to enjoy today, if you're listening to the Truth Network, is we have Amy Cabo's show, The Cure. It's coming on at 1 o'clock Eastern Time. And today's show is kind of got a question to it. Is hypnosis Christian? Is that something, have you ever thought about it? So that's what they're going to talk. It's live. You'll be able to talk into that. But, Jerry, as I was praying, God really led me to keep praying Psalm 68. And as I kept praying it all week, there were some passages that I want to highlight for you that I think are really significant. But also, if you really want a fun thing to do, read Psalm 68. And then see how God answered that psalm in Isaiah 61. Because in Isaiah 61, you might remember Isaiah saying that, you know, I've been anointed to preach good news to the poor, you know, healing to the captives, you know, I'm going to bind up the broken heart, all those things, set the captives free. That's Isaiah 61. And it goes on into some beautiful stuff about the vengeance of our God and stuff that has yet to come in Isaiah 61. So, fun thing, pray Psalm 68 and then go back and see how God's going to answer that thing. But I wonder if you'll pray with me right now as we just go through this psalm. And Jerry, feel free to kick in any thoughts that you have. So Psalm 68, let God arise, right? Like the sun, man. Let his enemies be scattered. Let those also who hate him flee before him. And I'm going to move on to verse 5 where it says, a father of the fatherless and a defender of widows. When you get a sense of God's heart, he is all about orphans and widows. And it says that God is in his holy habitation, and God sets the solitary in families. In other words, he's all about adoption, and he's all about community, like what Nancy was talking about. At your church, hopefully you've got a community, somebody where you can begin to spot those people around you. And he brings out those who are bound, and he brings them into prosperity. But the rebellious, they dwell in a dry land. I mean, they may have all kinds of stuff, but if you're around them much, you're going to find out it's pretty dry where they're hanging out, okay? And so moving down to verse 12, which is really, really, really cool, it says, kings of armies flee, but she who remains at home divides the spoil. Well, she happens to be Jesus's bride, okay? and that word remains at home, I about jumped out of my seat when I looked at it in Hebrew. It means abide. And very specifically, abiding in a sheepfold. Okay? So if you'll just stay in Jesus, if you'll just abide in the sheepfold, right, you're gonna divide the spoil. This is absolutely beautiful, and it's right there, and I'm telling you that the word is abide. And Jesus gave it to us in John 15, right? And if you abide in me, and everything's going to be all right. So absolutely really cool. Well, the place that God originally put me in Psalm 68 was in verse 28, where it says, "You, God, have commanded your strength." Now, that's the VARPLE sword. So you have commanded your strength. And then this is my favorite part. "Strengthen, O God, what you have done for us." In other words, take your VARPLE sword, give it to me, help me be strong with it, and use it for your kingdom, for what you've already done. In other words, I loved it. Somebody said, you know, most religions of the world are do, 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 do. But Christianity is D-O-N-E, done. It's done. Jesus did it all for us on the cross, right? So I love that. "Strengthen, O God, what you have already done." It's done. It's so awesome. Well, so I was just thinking about this strength that's being yoked to the plow or being taking hold of the VARPLE sword, whatever that may look at. And then look at the end of the psalm. So moving down to verse 34 and 35, it says, ascribe, in other words, give strength to God. Give your strength. Give your VARPLE sword. Say, here you go. Whatever makes you, whatever you delight in, whatever that looks like, if it's radio or if it's praying or whatever, give the strength to God. His excellence is over Israel, and his strength is in the clouds. Well, actually, it's in the firmament, if you really think about that in Hebrew. And you think about the firmament being where the rain comes from. So much comes down through the firmament, those sunlight beams and all those things. Well, he's coming down, I'm telling you. And see, David is finishing this with where he began. It's like, man, God is coming, like the sun is coming up tomorrow morning. And he wants to meet with you, and he's going to fill you with light so you can see where to use your VARPLE sword. And he ends it with verse 35, "Oh God, you are more awesome than your holy plans and your holy places." Excuse me. "You're more awesome than your holy places. To God of Israel, he who gives strength and power to his people." He's saying, Robbie, you got some VARPLE swords, okay?
Use them.
Use them for his glory. Don't photobomb Jesus. He gave them to you. They're a reflection of him. Right? So give him the glory for what it is, you know, for your laugh or for your prayer life or you know, and think about it. What a beautiful thing to call out somebody's VARPLE sword, right, Jerry?
And you know, that as you're reading that, one thing that just always comes to mind, especially hearing David when he writes, you know, one thing about it is time is timeless. When I say that is, you know what? We are still living what David is describing, because we still live in a world that the human side of us so many times chases after the temporal and the, you know, sort of like the sprinter, the quick things and stuff. But God tells us, you know what? Just come and bask with me. Just come and let my glory shine through you. And then we'll be like the widow in the home and stuff. Just stick with it, because those blessings are more than any of the temporal stuff that we're human. We our eye goes to that little shiny whatever it may be off in the
right
distance, because that's what we're drawn to. But God says, you know what? Don't. That's temporal. That's not going to last.
Yeah.
My love for you and what I'm going to do on what I've done on the cross will last.
It's done, and it's day by day, and he's got us. Those who stay in the sheepfold. So fear not. It's awesome stuff. So, you know, thank you again for everybody that participated in Jesus Labor Love, what it's doing. Thank you for the listeners that support this show and the stations that carry it. It's just absolutely awesome. I'm so grateful. But, you know, I got to tell you, remember, slow down. Jesus walked everywhere he went, got it all done in 33 years. And, man, this week, why not call out somebody's VARPLE sword that you see and really encourage them and help them start yielding that thing?
V This is the Truth Network.